next great NHL offensive player.
Oh, boy.
He can handle the puck and do all these things at top speed.
Sergei Fedorov has really brought his game up a notch. I mean, the legs, the speed, the grace that he has. But when he's getting the puck at full speed, I don't care who you are, it's going to be very difficult to stop him unless someone's holding him up to the neutral zone or hooking him up just a little bit.
Sergei Fedorov leads the NHL rookies in points. He's second on his own team in points. Bobby Clark, the manager of the Minnesota North Stars. Here's a look at the rookie scoring. Absolutely inundated with Europeans this year. Clark says that Fedorov would have been number one overall in 89 if the teams knew he'd be available. Many opposing coaches have said he's been the Red Wings' best player. And Bob, no visor, tough, 64 shots on goal. He's one European that doesn't mind shooting.
Heinzelman got him going early with three straight goals, assisted on two others. Fedorov is in there!
This guy is going to be one of the next great NHL offensive players.
Oh, boy.
He can handle the puck and do all these things at top speed as he turns Luke Richardson into a spinning door, rolls in and fires it by Peter Ng. And this kid is 20 years old, folks. He's going to be a beauty.
While Iserman's remarkable consistency has made him one of the game's elite players, it is the love of speed that has propelled second-year sensation Sergei Fedorov to all-star status in the NHL.
I like very much speed because it makes you so excited. I like my fast car, I like, of course, speed on the ice too. If you got speed, you can do whatever you want.
On the ice, there's no one quite like Sergei Fedorov, a 21-year-old Russian marksman with lightning quick speed. Fedorov's dazzling moves can leave fans in absolute amazement.
Fedorov, watch the play in front. He scores! Sergei Fedorov with a great individual effort. And here's a chance for Fedorov.
He should be in.
I get to see everything here because I can't skate fast enough to keep up with him. But you know, he's a tremendous player. I mean, skates unbelievable. It's different speeds. You know, he'll skate through the neutral ice kind of nonchalant, and then all of a sudden, boom! He's past guys that don't get beat very regular in the NHL. You know, he watches Steve Yzerman, how hard he works every night, and you know, I think he'll learn from that. And he's a phenomenal player, and I think he's only going to get better.
This season, Fedorov emerged as the finest two-way center in the NHL, and by season's end was a top candidate for the Selke Award for the league's best defensive forward. He's a player whose extraordinary abilities helped raise his teammates to another level. For much of the year, Fedorov played alongside forwards Paul Izobard and Sean Burr, providing a 1-2-3 punch that became known as the knockout line. Matched against opponents' highest scores, they continually turned takeaways into breakaways. If Fedorov was the lightning on the line, then Sean Burr provided the thunder.
Right off the heel of the stick, and the penalty is over now. Red Wings kill yet another one. Here's Fedorov in the play. Scores! Fedorov out of the box. And he scores a goal. 2-1 Detroit.
The game for the Red Wings goes through the legs of Potvin. Fedorov comes out of the box. It's a 3-on-2 rush, a drop pass right here, and there's a mix-up. Krushelnicki and Mironov both went to the same player. Nobody filled in the slot, and from about 30 feet out, it goes right by Felix Potvin, and the score is 2-1, Red Wings.
Fedorov, meanwhile, in a rush without the helmet. Fedorov to down the straight to Fedorov, they score!
Outstanding.
Copy to Fedorov without the helmet. Fedorov for his second goal. Scores! He's got two!
Tough.
Kozlov got it off. Fedorov scores!
Before this year, Sergei Fedorov might not have caught your eye unless you like defensive hockey. The former Russian standout earned his reputation and his shot at the NHL, shadowing others.
The fact that he was a good defensive player has helped his offense because he's especially in the beginning of the year, he stole a lot of pucks.
This year really was the transition year for him, where he turned from sort of being satisfied with his offensive game to making more demands on himself and getting the point totals that he ended up with.
I talked to Brian a little bit, and basically he talked to me. He told me be more kind of selfish, more shoot the puck more, you know.
Sergei, he's excellent all-around player, and he's never been selfish. It's a Russian system.
I think he started to understand the North American way. You get more points, you have a chance to get a better contract.
The result of changing his style has been dramatic. A new 4-year, $12 million contract, and a label as the best two-way player in the game.
He's 100% both ways, and killing penalties, and you don't find a guy that really comes back, you know, to the crease or behind the net getting pucks.
Everything happened offensively became from defensive zone. I really enjoyed to do that, and it's kind of helped me a lot and take my game in next level.
For Kozlov. Kozlov cutting in. Drops it back for Larionov. Recky was there. Larionov behind the net. Sends it out to Fedorov. Scores! Sergei Fedorov!
Bingo, bango. Here comes the hook. Have mercy on me. Patrick Waugh will go. Good Lord. I mean, it's Larionov again who made the play here. What's his tally here? You're right.
Well, you know what? The great play he made on the last goal by Kozlov to Patisov. He doesn't get an assist.
You're kidding me.
Because it went from Patisov to Fedorov. But right here, yes, I believe he'll get an assist. Fedorov's 12th of the year.
Now they're trying to delay here. Jablonski is coming out. They'll get the cheer. And 9-1. We've barely played over half a hockey game.
Forsberg went down low and overskated the pass, and a 3-on-2 the other way. Fedorov, Larionov, and Kozlov. Fedorov in front. He scores! Plenty of patience, and then he's got an empty netter. Big goal for Fedorov, his second point of the game. He also has an assist.
Konstantinov, that deflects out deep. Races on, Wayne Gretzky. Gretzky moving in. Gretzky's got Hall, and it's taken away by Sergei Fedorov.
Wayne Gretzky had what he thought was a 2-on-1. Watch him jump ahead of Fedorov, and then Sergei put it into overdrive.
42 seconds left in regulation. Mano a mano tonight.
It sure helps to have the young legs right now. The matchup continues. Fedorov has been out there with Steve Yzerman against Wayne Gretzky and Brett Hull for virtually all their even strength shifts, all but one, and we're up into the mid-20s now, I believe, in shifts. But that has been the matchup. And Fedorov and Steve Yzerman, if you're looking for control and territorial play and all those other things, are winning the matchup. The score is still 0-0. Well, this game resembles the first two for Wayne Gretzky. The Detroit Red Wings smothered Wayne. Then in games 3, 4, and 5, Detroit really strayed from their left wing lock and their tight defensive system, and Wayne Gretzky became a factor. Just like most players in this game, as soon as the Detroit Red Wings clamp it down and put somebody out there to take away space and time, Wayne's had a tough go of it here in game 7. And there's the man that has taken away most of the space and most of the time.
Sergei Fedorov. Carson.
It was Bill McCreary. Now it's Fedorov behind the net. And Murphy will try to work it ahead.
2-on-1.
Fedorov with Sandstrom. Fedorov shot. Score! Bingo. Red Wings have tied it 1-1 on the goal by Sergei Fedorov just 35 seconds into the second period. They're on their feet again.
Well, the pass sprung Fedorov. Here's the last looks at it. 2-on-1, defenseman's got to take the pass away. Left Fedorov to the goaltender, and he beats Waugh cleanly to the blocker side. Good wrist shot. And for the first time tonight, Patrick Waugh looks human. Sandstrom and Fedorov in a 2-on-1.
Well, now the situation is Sergei Fedorov's 29th of the season at 35 seconds of the period, and Colorado has the power play.
There's been questions about the Russian players when it comes playoff time, but no question about their productivity this year, Darren.
Look at that one. They put a point on the board, 10-0, and the goals for per game for the entire team, 3.2, and under a half a goal per game, and already in this contest, Igor Larionov has scored a goal for the Red Wings.
Power play goal that Detroit has credited to Larionov. That was changed during the intermission. Center, Fedorov scores! Sergei Fedorov! Their second power play goal of the game, and they tied it up at 2.
Sergei Fedorov has come out in the third period. Watch this rush. He jumped by Gusarov, jumped over his stick, and whistled one just wide of Patrick Waugh. Kept it alive, and then Steve Yzerman made a really good play to set up Sergei Fedorov. And when Fedorov back to Steve Yzerman, Fedorov never even shot this. He just kind of redirected it, kind of a redirection shovel that Patrick Waugh was beaten by. Oh, right under the right arm. Right through the right armpit.
Kicked here for Larionov. Fired wide.
Larionov again. Hash marks. The point to the line. One-timer. Fedorov. He scores!
What a try by Fedorov. A one-timer from 60 feet.
And it's 4-0 Detroit.
In his tracks. That gave him enough time to turn around and find Sergei Fedorov, and the puck was bouncing. Patrick Waugh absolutely robbed Fedorov on the first one, but he stayed with it on the rebound. But Kozlov made it happen. Boy, did he put a move on Ozolinch. Wide open was Fedorov in front. Patrick Waugh made the first save, as he does so often. But Sergei Fedorov, who missed a lot of this hockey game after the wind was knocked out of him, right now has scored a gigantic goal.
Detroit, get it out. Up to Fedorov. He's coming in there. Fedorov shoots. Scores! Fedorov with a decoy. Murphy right up there with him. Picked the top corner. And it's a 3-1 Detroit lead.
This is the one area where Philadelphia has dominated in the first couple of games. Faceoffs. They lose it. Fedorov shoots. Scores!
Smooth play over the line. Fedorov. Shanahan, Kozlov, in front, Fedorov scores! It's in the goal, but there'll be a phone call on this one, I do believe.
Absolutely, and
this goal may not count. Kozlov walks out of the corner. There's the shot. And Shanahan, oh no, he got his foot out of there. It's 4-1.
Bird and Nesta. Lindros was on it for a second. Philadelphia on the power play will try to pass it around. Fedorov lost his stick. He has to play the man. And he does a pretty good job of that.
One final thing, Mike. Remember the tour of Russia in 1989 after you'd won it with Calgary? You ever think you'd play with five of their best to share in this?
I hope I don't go back to Moscow this September, but they're five phenomenal players. They're unbelievable. Every one of them, Larionov is just a total class act, a great, smart player that has all the tools. Batisov, every one of them, Sergei Fedorov, they're all unbelievable. And when they're at their best, this hockey club usually wins hockey games.
Just like you. Way to go.
Thank you very much, Ron.
Sergei Fedorov, I'll tell you what, we talked the other day, and you said to me that we love the cup as Russians just as much as anybody else does. Would you like to say that again?
Well, that was even more right now because we won it. And absolutely, it's the most desirable trophy to get, and everybody plays so well, and I love everybody. I love my teammates. Yeah.
Who do you think of, Sergei, when you raise the cup? Do you think of family, somebody back home who enters your mind when you've won?
All my family live with me for 3-4 years. What do you think we're doing here? And it feels unbelievable. And I'd like to say happy birthday, Anna. And I'd like to thank my mom and dad. They always support me, and I'm sure they have a couple drinks while we're playing. So for us, too easy to score, so that's kind of tradition. Yeah. And it feels great. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sergei. Good luck.
Thanks.
Note that Shannon has fallen into a little bit of the Chateau Bow Wow a little bit with Scotty Bowman. But Bowman, of course, is... Here's a chance and Fedorov scores, and it's Shanahan who is on the ice with Eiserman to give the Red Wings the first goal of the hockey game, Darren. Put the big line, Fedorov, Eiserman, and Shanahan out there. Eiserman makes the backhand pass. And good play by Shanahan to cause that distraction. And Patrick Waugh, Shanahan jumps up here, and Patrick Waugh has no idea where that puck is. Nice pass by Eiserman. Backhand pass right to Fedorov, and Fedorov, quick decision, just let her go. Here is Ozilich. Dangerous pass intercepted. Fedorov, he's away. Fedorov in up. Patrick Waugh scores! What a play that is by Fedorov after Ozilich gives it up. Oh, he sweeps it back across the grain on the backhand. Keep your eye on Fedorov, bringing it back to the right. Lifts his stick and then goes to the stick side. What a play that is. What a play by Fedorov. That's the great individual stuff. Could break open a hockey game. Man.
I'll tell you what, that delay is probably the best thing that happens in Detroit. The Coyotes have gathered some momentum after the top goal.
Murphy with a pass that went off Lidstrom. Eiserman on. He got it out of Fedorov. In on a breakaway. Look. Shoots. Score! At 30 seconds of the first period.
Eiserman there with a cross-ice pass. And you can see Fedorov just take off. Happy Boulin got a piece of the puck, but not enough on the play. Carney's the left defenseman. And he was beaten to the outside by Fedorov. You can see the puck hit Happy Boulin go right up underneath the crossbar, 1-0 in favor of the Red Wings. First shot on goal. Fedorov stayed wide. Eiserman with a brilliant pass.
Batisov off the board. Looking up, staying onside. Fedorov's got help. Fedorov shot. He scores! That's why you pay $1 billion. Sergei Fedorov! And Detroit takes a 2-1 lead.
He is an amazing man. 13 shots. In game two, nothing to show for it. That meant one thing. He was hungry when Big Dog.
2:02, the time of the penalty. First penalty of the hockey game. And the Red Wings on the power play. They were 2-4. It was a key part of the game number one of that show.
Face-off win.
He had some help. Verbeek was in there battling as well. On the left side of your screen, though, is Thomas Holmstrom, number 96. They're going to give it a little give and go right here. Holmstrom then goes to the front of the net, causing a screen. How on earth is the goaltender going to see that? And a pinpoint perfect shot by Sergei Fedorov. One quick play from the hash marks to the middle. Doesn't hit anybody, and you can see the reaction of Felix Potvin. He didn't flinch, didn't move whatsoever. Great screen by Thomas Holmstrom in front of the net.
Same thing, and the young kids will have to do all the exertion drills.
Here's Sergei Fedorov for the World All-Stars. Their second racer, Dmytro, 15-2-1-2, the best of the first two skaters.
Mary Melrose, if you had this drive.
There's the new number to beat.
That's just a stride you. Hard to teach that, isn't it?
Two prettiest skaters in the NHL are Fedorov and Mike McDonald. I think they're the two best skaters in the world. The two of them, they skate very similar, full-legged, great mobility, and go side to side.
Right to do.
See him again? Chris has got a place here in Malibu. He spends his summers here, and he's got his family. His kids, Dean and Jake, I know we're down here playing hockey, and they went back to the place this afternoon.
Okay, Fedorov, 97, easily. Final shooter for the World All-Stars and maybe the ultimate winner.
I should know better than to go against the goalie than used to having shots going by us.
Second chance.
Oh!
0.5. Take that, Anna.
As I said, who has a better life than Sergei? He's going to clean up the All-Star game.
Who's got a better serve?
Man, what a rocket.
She can't serve this hard.
Look at this.
Oh, he got everything into it.
Perfect form.
Perfect. That puck was in a perfect position, just a little bit behind, and he was able to take a slight.
Chelios would go to the near side as the Ducks change it up. Hull looking. Hull found an open man again, cutting to the net. Shot score! Sergei Fedorov! Bowman said, move up, defenseman! He did!
And Brian Murray has seen enough. He wants to at least pull Steve Shields out of the pit of alligators before they eat him alive. Great pass over to Robitaille. Watch this little saucer pass. Oh, baby. Landed right on the tape of Fedorov. He stopped it with the back part of his blade and just one-timed it. Our Southwest Airlines gold cam will show Steve Shields back in his net pretty deep, but with Fedorov, what are you going to do? Come out to challenge him? He goes around you.
Gets it across. Lipson fakes the shot. Gets the return feed. Here's Fedorov. Shot!
This league are going to stop that bullet. My goodness, what a pass from Lidstrom along the ice and in a, oh my goodness, what a shot. I mean, it just jumped, it just sprung off his stick like trampoline effect with a driver. I mean, that thing was humming. And you remember at the All-Star Skills competition that we had on ESPN, 101 miles an hour standing still or skating into a shot for Sergei Fedorov. And that was a rocket. Good execution and a good pass. A little saucer pass by Lidstrom.
Shanahan again. A lot of room. Shot. Save made by Kluche. Rebound. Score! Sergei Fedorov, 1-0 Detroit.
Well, the Detroit Red Wings left the Joe Louis Arena down two games to Vancouver, and they left this building to a chorus of boos. They come back as heroes. They take a 1-0 lead here. This is why you can't afford to take penalties, especially unnecessary ones against the Detroit Red Wings. Brendan Shanahan with a couple of good scoring opportunities, and finally, Sergei Fedorov from the high slot. Too much firepower.
That will be the fifth power play of the series. 5-for-18 for Detroit against Vancouver. It's away. Opel could not hold it in. 2-on-1. Fedorov's on the right. Hull now 2-on-2. Over to Fedorov. One-handed. Scored! Oh, what a tip! And Detroit making a mockery.
When Sergei Fedorov came on the ice, that he wanted something out of this game. And was just going to go and grab it and shake it until he got it. Two goals and one assist here in the first period for Sergei Fedorov. Peter Skudra, I think, was waiting for Sergei Fedorov to control this puck with two hands.
I don't need two stinking hands. One's enough. Sergei Fedorov, amazing.
The guys to back him up, like Yuri Fischer did, Kirk Maltby there. He's going to go and take a chance.
And he did. Detroit changing behind the play. Sergei Fedorov, a shot, scores!
Had 15 shots in the last two games without a goal. Sergei Fedorov launches a bomb. It might have been tipped. It might have been a knuckleball. Patrick Love, he's a stand-up guy, will say, this one I should have had. 2-0 Detroit. And the roof is caving in here on the Colorado Avs.
Hit a stick. Went up. He went down.
It almost looked like it curved on the way in. Yeah, baby. Now I've got two to work with. That's what Dominic Hasek was saying.
To him, picked back up by Hedekin, who could not clear. Here's Eiserman, a chance, deflected, Urbe down, score! Sergei Fedorov, Tomas Holmstrom, Steve Eiserman combining. And Urbe, I think, wanted to argue interference with Holmstrom banging into him.
He did, but when he didn't see anybody else arguing, I think he figured out that it was Aaron Ward that pushed Holmstrom back on top of him. Watch Holmstrom here, 96 for the Red Wings. Brett Hedekin tried to get it out. Steve Eiserman stopped it. Right there, you saw Aaron Ward, number 4 for the Carolina Hurricanes, spin around and push Holmstrom onto Urbe from our Southwest Airlines goal cam. Once Holmstrom got position on Aaron Ward, Ward could only fling him back into Urbe. And the rebound came right out.
Penalty, they kill off Steve Eiserman's penalty and get a goal like that.
Would have been
pretty much put it away.
Would have been a sour dressing room if LA had tied this game.
couldn't stop him.
Butterfly! Couldn't stop him. Dixie! I couldn't stop him. And now I'm a janitor! Custodial engineer! Hey, buddy! Just wax there! Jerk!
Welcome to Burgerama. May I take your order?
Yeah, we get a double cheese. Didn't you used to play for the Blackhawks?
Yeah! Used to play for the Blackhawks until Sergei Fedorov showed up. His explosive skating style and a powerful shot that exposed a weak glove hand! Weak, weak, weak glove hand!
Down one double cheese.
Mr. Long Hair Russian Freak Boy skating around his fancy Nike skates! I was employee of the month. I was employee of the month!